Hey, I'm Alex Radcliffe from Board Game Co. And today we're having a conversation around first-person shooters and how they're missing their mark. I literally just thought of that pun and I'm so proud of myself, but we're going to move past that. First-person shooters. First-person shooters are... We're going to be talking about five first-person shooters today, as well as, of course, the video game conversation in general. The nature of how, over the past year, we've seen a lot of IPs. A lot of IPs translated into board games, whether it's movies, whether it's, you know, Disney Larkana, whether it's first-person shooters or any other video games. More and more IPs are finding their way into the board game space as a way to bring in new board gamers, and also as a way to, like, you know, sell stuff. IPs are frequently there to sell stuff, and we're going to touch upon that more today. What I find interesting is that first-person shooters in particular seem to not be hitting the same way other IP translations are. They seem to constantly be disappointments to their creators, to their backers, to the people who are following them and want something from them. First-person shooters are not translating as well into board games as one might think they would, despite the huge amount of hype and buzz and follower counts that these games will get. They're just not translating. We're going to be talking about five in particular today, as well as the general conversation around them. And I don't know if there's any strong takeaway to this video. Just a heads up, if you're looking for some, you know, specific takeaway. Sometimes the videos I have a takeaway, and sometimes it's just a conversation around what's currently going on. And the nature of these first-person shooters, what's currently going on is they're not hitting their mark quite as much there. See, that term does work. It does work. But starting off the bat, we have Far Cry. Far Cry over here from Funforge Games did $33,000. It did not even break $100,000. It just didn't land at all. And I actually did a full dedicated video on Far Cry. We're going to come back to that. In fact, we're going to just circle through these games and then come back to all of them. Then we have Actively right now. We have Call of Duty, the board game. Actively, as an Activision pun. Again, not intended. Not great. Honestly, I'm not here for the puns. You shouldn't be here for it either. But Call of Duty, the board game from Arcane Wonders. $160,000 as of when I'm filming this video. This video might be going up after the campaign ends, but I'm guessing it ends somewhere in the range of 350, maybe 400K on a campaign that I guarantee you they thought would do 500 to a million on the lowest of the lowest ends, likely closer to 2 million, if not more, for this game. Then we have Apex Legends. Apex Legends over here. This one over here, Apex Legends from Glass Cannon Unplugged. This one did just shy of 800, well, not just shy, they did 832,000 euro for this game, which is a decent amount of money. But this campaign had 40,000 plus people following it. And again, I guarantee you that the Apex Legends, that Glass Cannon Unplugged, I guarantee you people were expecting more for this campaign. And there's reasons. All of these campaigns have reasons. Every single last one has a reason why it didn't do as well as people thought it might have. But they still, at the end of the day, did not do as well as people thought they would have. Then we have Six Siege over here, which did $1.54 million raised. A decent amount for sure from Mythic Games. We're not even going to talk about where it is now. Well, it's not true. We will talk about where it's now, but we'll talk about that later in the video. But despite bringing in $1.5 million, again, they thought it would do more. And then we have Stalker from Wake Realms, the highest by far, coming in at $3.7 million on a first-person shooter, which is tremendous. $15,000 raised, $3.7 million. This, with no question, this is the best one of the bunch as far as how well it did, how well it was received. $3.7 million is not a failure by any means. And yet again, with 40,000 plus people following the campaign, I guarantee you Awakened Realms thought it would do more. All of these campaigns, to a certain extent, did not hit their mark. They did not hit the target funding goals that these campaigns had. I mean, the funding goals, sure, but the goals for the creators of what they thought the IP would do, of what they thought a first-person shooter converted to a board game would do, none of these campaigns hit. And again, we'll talk a bit more about each one and why I think they are where they are. But ultimately, first-person shooters don't seem to be landing the same way other IPs are. Other IPs, I mentioned Larkana already in this video. Larkana hits the market with an absolute smash hit. It doesn't matter the cash grabber or not. People are loving it and hunting it down and obsessed with it. Some of them, sure, because they think it might be the next big thing. But many others are just diving into it and having a good time. Larkana is here to stay, or at least for several years will be here to stay. But then far more than that, if you're looking at even just video games, we have This War of Mine, we have Resident Evil series, which is almost first-person shooter, but more of a third-person shooter. We have Horizon Zero Dawn, Elden Ring, Elder Scrolls, Heroes of Might and Magic, Bloodborne, Stellaris, many more video games have been and are and will be continued to translate it into board games. both in crowdfunding, both in non-crowdfunding, and they all seem to be doing just fine, or most seem to be doing just fine. Did I mention Monster Hunter World? I think I missed Monster Hunter World. We have that as well. There are so many of these games that are being translated into board games and are doing tremendously well. And I can never speak for any individual creator's goals of how well they thought something would do, but I can say that so many campaigns are consistently knocking it out of the park, and first-person shooters always seem to end up against the wall. I think there's a few reasons for it. I think sometimes it's a campaign by campaign breakdown, and sometimes it's the nature of what a first-person shooter is. And I'll say it doesn't help that none of these games have delivered yet. I mentioned Far Cry Beyond, that one cancelled. Call of Duty is currently active. Apex Legends will show up at some point, but only just funded. Six Siege is, I don't even know what's going to happen with that one. And then Stalker, again, only just funded, so it's new. But that means we don't have a first-person shooter that we can really, truly look at. We do have Doom. To be fair, we do have Doom from Fantasy Flight, but that didn't go through crowdfunding. I don't have enough data on the numbers there. That's the only real first-person shooter that I could at least think of. Perhaps there's others that I'm not thinking of, but we just don't have any first-person shooters that have been turned into board games on the market. I've actually had the chance to play most of these games. I've played Call of Duty. I've played all five of these first-person shooters. I've played Far Cry Beyond. I played Call of Duty. I played Apex Legends. I played Six Siege, and I played Stalker. And I have my own personal opinions on each one of where they are, but most people haven't had that chance, which means they are going to struggle because of the nature of the fact that by their very nature of what a first-person shooter is, in order to translate into a board game, what you have to do, what's inherent in that conversion, is a separation, a disconnect on the mechanics of what makes a first-person shooter a first-person shooter. Games like Monster Hunter World, games like Heroes of Might and Magic, or This War of Mine, so many of these games, there are different mechanics at play, different things that make them a game in different ways, but with a first-person shooter, they are inherently driven by that aspect of moving a mouse or control or whatnot and moving around the board and shooting someone. The mechanic of being a first-person shooter inherently does not translate into a board game. Which means when you try to translate into a board game, you are actually taking the theme of a first-person shooter and you're making it into something else. In the case of Far Cry, it was a dungeon crawler. Far Cry was turned into a dungeon crawler. It may not seem like it if you pay attention to the videos, but ultimately speaking, Far Cry was a dungeon crawler. It was a game where you were a cooperative game, where you'd wander into various locations, enemies would spawn, and you'd go through your sequence of trying to take them out before they took you out. It was a dungeon crawler. That's all it was, with the facade of a first-person shooter on top of it, which is not a bad thing. But a simple dungeon crawler on its own, standing on its own merits, would have done better. But the disconnect between a Far Cry is and then it becoming a first-person shooter. And we're not even talking about the disconnect on theme. I'm a huge Far Cry fan, and I thought Far Cry should be like jungles. Mostly just jungles is what I thought Far Cry should be. And instead, Far Cry was this Russian theme. It did not look like Far Cry at all. So there's a disconnect on theme, but the inherent disconnect on mechanics. Call of Duty goes for an entirely different approach than any first-person shooter I've seen so far in the way that it kind of simulates the real-time. Not actually real-time, but it simulates the idea of a real-time experience by through the way you plan out several actions in a row and then resolve them each one at a time and then try to have players turn and face each other. So it's a tactical skirmish game, but it's a tactical skirmish game with a degree of real-time simulation to make it into some facade or simile of a first-person shooter, but it's still not a first-person shooter. Apex Legends is a skirmish game with powers and abilities, but ultimately just a skirmish game. Six Siege, a similar approach, a skirmish game with powers and abilities and gear and all these things, but ultimately just a skirmish game. And then Stalker, again, is a dungeon crawler. That's all it is. Again, cooperative experience, you control the characters, you face off against the map, a degree of campaign and evolution, but it's a dungeon crawler, which means every first-person shooter, by their very nature of converting them into a board game, they lose what they intrinsically are. You cannot possibly mentally wrap your head around it. When you translate Elder Scrolls from the video game to a board game, the concepts of what you're doing are still present. But when you translate a first-person shooter into a board game, you are actually entirely disconnecting the main mechanic of the genre. They're called first-person shooters, and board games aren't and can't. Cannot be a first-person shooter. And I think that's the first challenge these games all face. The first challenge that every single first-person shooter video game translating to a board game faces is the audience, the target audience, not understanding that despite their appeal to that thing, despite wanting to like Apex Legends, despite wanting to like Call of Duty, if you're fine getting past Activision and all that stuff, despite all that desire, you don't necessarily know or get a good sense that the thing that intrinsically pulled you towards that thing in the first place, the mechanics of it being a first-person shooter, those are going to be gone as soon as you play the board game. And again, all that is made worse by the fact that none of these games have actually delivered yet. Which means I've enjoyed a variety of these games. I think Apex Legends is great. I think Six Siege is excellent. I think Stalker is incredible. I think Call of Duty is great. Far Cry Beyond, I thought the mechanics were fine, but the theme really pushed me out of that one. But overall, these games that I have the opportunity to try and like. I mean, when Six Siege delivers, if it ever does, there will be a lot of people talking about how good of a skirmish game it is. Because it is an excellent skirmish game. One of the best skirmish games I've played. But it's not a first-person shooter. Which means the reason someone may have been interested in the first place is inherently gone when you go through that. And this disconnect on mechanics, that disconnect goes further down the rabbit hole, because the disconnect creates a further lack of trust in what this thing will become. Sure, I'm interested in Stalker, but, you know, 42,000 people were interested in Stalker, and only 15,000 of those people backed the game because there's a disconnect, there's a lack of trust. And the fact that these are IP-based, and the IP-based with a disconnect on the mechanics further kind of has that mental aspect. We talked about cash grabs earlier. It kind of makes you think as a consumer, well, this is just a cash grab. Because when you throw Six Siege onto, when you throw Apex Legends onto a board game, and the thing that was a first person battle royale, when that thing is expired, I mean, Apex Legends, if I recall correctly, I'd have to double check it. Apex Legends, I have to refresh myself on the rules in that one. But if I recall correctly, it's a battle royale, and if your characters die, they just come back. I think. I have to double check how it works over there. You get points for it, but the characters come back, which means it's not a battle royale, and it's not a first person shooter. And yet, it's based off a battle royale first-person shooter, so how do you mentally connect that? And so it's easy for the consumer, for the target audience, to think that it's just a cash grab. You're just here to pull people in with the IP, but it doesn't have to be a good game behind it. And even though there are good games behind it, in many cases they are, it has that further disconnect and that trust aspect there. And that's also why I think one of the games that has done the best, Stalker, which is the best first-person shooter, I think a big part of that is because I think Awakened Realms has done a good job over the years of cultivating an audience that trusts Awakened Realms. I think Stalker did 3.7 million compared to, you know, the others doing, you know, not funding, a few hundred thousand, 800,000 euro, and then 1.5 million, and then Stalker coming in at 3.7 million. I think that happened because the trust in the creator. I don't think Stalker has the highest appeal for many of these first-person shooters, but I think Awakened Realms has the highest consistent fan base that looked past all these disconnects, that looked past the perception of what a first-person shooter is, that looks past that potential aspect of it being an IP cash grab. Awakened Realms never did any IP content before. They always had their own things, and when they finally for the first time do one, it's taken, combined the loyalty towards Awakened Realms and combined their history of not doing IPs until now, it does kind of mentally put there, like, there is a higher degree of trust in the company. And the company trust does help put something out there when it doesn't have any mechanical tie-in to the thing that it's based on. This also lends itself to the conversation around Six Siege. With Six Siege having the issues that it did, I think a huge part of that audience is the target audience for first-person shooters. There's going to be overlap with people who back Six Siege and people who want to back Apex Legends, Call of Duty, and Stalker. And then having the issues and the drama that Six Siege has had certainly doesn't help. It doesn't help crowdfunding in general. It doesn't help board games in general. But I think it further does not help first-person shooters in general. There's no clear consensus, no clear outcome for this video. I just thought it was interesting that every single time a first-person shooter is announced, it tends to have a large degree of hype, of buzz, and a following around them. And then when the campaigns launch, they don't seem to do quite as well as people thought they would have, as I thought they would have. Something about the genre still manages to maintain the audience's interest. But it doesn't maintain the audience clicking to back now. When push comes to shove and they have to make a choice over what they're going to spend their hard-earned dollars on, first-person shooters seem to be facing an uphill battle. Now make no mistake. For a long time I've said that if I could pick one video game that was turned into a board game, it would be BioShock. Technically it was. But very differently. Speaking of first-person shooters that were turned into games that didn't do well, BioShock the board game did not do well because it was not a first-person shooter, or even remotely close. I still want BioShock. I still have that sense of faith. And again, I'm in the fortunate position of having played most of these games. And I think Call of Duty, Apex, Six Siege, and Stalker are all tremendously good games, even if they, admittedly, do not feel like first-person shooters. Where does that leave us? No one in particular. I think the translation of video games into board games is going to continue to happen. I think as some of these games deliver, there'll be a higher degree of audience trust that creators know how to take a first-person shooter, take it outside that mechanic, and still deliver something that's adjacent enough that you are enjoying yourself and having a good time. It may not be the original thing that it was by the very nature of it being a first-person shooter, but it'll still be a good time for those involved. None of them have really hit their mark yet. Stalker comes close. Stalker definitely comes close. Ironically, Stalker is the one that probably feels the least like a first-person shooter to me. I think Six Siege really did a very solid job nailing it. I think Six Siege might be my favorite from the bunch, but it's hard to say for sure. Either way, until next time, I'm Alex Radcliffe from Board Game Co. Let me know down below which first-person shooter you still hold out hope for, which ones you still want to see turned into a board game, and why. And until next time, I hope you have a good one.